Hey everyone, so here I'm doing exercise 7.1 and all the four questions are going to do here, and I have done exercise 7.2. You can find the solutions of each question in a playlist, or that's it. So let's start with the first question. It's a fill in the blanks question. So the question is, complete the following statements, and they have given three questions to us. The first one is, two line segments are congruent if dash. So congruent means when they have a same length, right? Congruent means they have a same thing, similar things, or same angle, or the measurement is same. So since they're talking about the line segment, so we'll say that two line segments are congruent if they are of a same length. So the answer, if they are of same length, if they have same length. So that's the answer for the first question. And the second one, so in the second question it is, among two congruent angles, one has a measure of 70 degree, the measure of the other angle is, since they're saying it's a congruent angle means the measurement is same. If one angle is 70 degree, it means the other angle has to be 70 degree. So your answer will be a 70 degree. Then third one, when we write angle A is equal to angle B, we actually mean that measurements of angle A and B are equal. So we'll write M stands for the measurement, so M of angle A will be same as M of angle B. That's it. Let's go to the next question. So next question is about, give any two real life examples for the congruent shape. So we have a many examples, so I'll just write the answer over here for the second question. So the first example, we like biscuits of the same packet, they almost have a same shape, right? So they are like congruent. And the shaving blades of a same brand again, so we'll write down the answer here. So the first one will be, biscuits of the same brand or same packet. It's not a brand, it should be a same packet. And the next one, it will be a shaving blade of the same brand. Shaving blade, shaving blades of the same brand. That's it. So that's the answer for the second question. Now moving on to the third question. So third question is, if triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED under the correspondence angle, this ABC is corresponding to FED, write all the corresponding congruent parts of the triangles. Or a corresponding part means we have to write down both segments, line segments and angle both. So let's start doing this one. Now since they have given ABC and then they have given FED, so the corresponding parts will be, it's like very clear to understand. Suppose AB I'm talking about, so AB will be congruent to FD. Okay, you have to just follow the sequence here. I cannot write AB is equal to ED. So ABC, it follows the same thing. So vertex A will be same as a vertex F, B will be same as a E, and C as a D. So AB, so I'll write down here. So AB will be same as a FD, FE. And the next one, so I'm talking about the line segments. And the next is BC. Now BC will be same as ED. So line segment BC and ED are same. And the third line segment will be AC. So AC will be equal to FD. So line segment AC will be same as FD. Now that was about the line segments. Now we'll talk about the angles. Now here angle A will be same as an angle F. So angle A will be same as angle F, and again angle B will be same as angle E, angle C will be same as angle D. So angle B is congruent to angle E and angle C is congruent to angle D. That's it. Okay, so that was the answer for the third question. I hope you have understood. Now let's move on to the next question. It's a fourth question. So the fourth question is, if DEF is congruent to BCA, write parts of triangle BCA that corresponds to. So we have to just write down the correspondence of this E, angle E, line segment EF, angle F and DF are corresponding to which parts of this triangle BCA. So let's do this one. So first one, so angle E will be equal to, we have to apply the same technique here. So again, so angle E will be equal to or correspondence or the congruent to, we can say angle C. So angle E is here and then C is here, so it's the center. So it is congruent to angle C. And the next one, line segment EF. So EF is here, so EF has to be equal to CA. So line segment CA. Then angle F. So angle F, so angle F is here, so angle F has to be equal to angle A. And the last one. So last one is line segment DF. So line segment DF will be congruent to, so we have a DF here. So this is a DF and it will be a BA. So it will be congruent to BA, line segment BA. That's it. So that was a really simple questions you have asked in this exercise. I hope you have understood this. In case you have any questions or doubts, please drop a comment. I'll try to answer them. And thank you so much for watching this.